What is up, dudes? My name is Freaky, and in today's video, we're going to be going over everything that has been removed feature-wise in Call of Duty Cold War's multiplayer and compared it to the Modern Warfare 2019's multiplayer. Now, this video is very crucial for anyone that just started playing Call of Duty and Modern Warfare in 2019, and that's your first ever Call of Duty. If you're not new to Call of Duty whatsoever, you're going to know a lot of these features are going to seem very similar to you, and they're not really going to be foreign, but there are some things in here that are a little bit different than what we've seen in previous Call of Duties to date. So the first one meaning the killstreaks. Killstreaks are now removed. There are now score streaks. If you don't know what score streaks are, basically if you do, kill someone, get an assist, hop an objective, finish an objective, no matter what you do, getting point-wise, they're going to help get towards your streaks. In this Call of Duty, at least in the alpha build that these people were playing on the Black Ops Cold War, they basically didn't reset on death. So in Modern Warfare, if you die one off of a kill streak, you can't just come back to life and still be one off of that kill streak. You'll have to reset your whole kill streak. In this game, it does not reset. Don't know if I'm a huge fan of that. I know it's really good for the low-level players. And honestly, for me, I play the multiplayer super casual now. Back in the day, that used to be the bread and butter. I used to go around, run like crazy, and try to get the streaks as much as possible. But sometimes I like to kick back and relax, play super casual. So this is going to be really good for casual players to be able to just get their streaks throughout the game, depending on how big of a kill streak they put on, because obviously a lot of these score streaks are going to have higher score to get them, and not everyone's going to get them every game, so you actually still have to be playing pretty well and play the OBJ. And if you're not playing the OBJ, you might not be able to do it in certain game types. We'll see, but that is the change up for score streaks today. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think about that change. And Ground War is not 32v32 anymore. That was the first thing that they kind of introduced that was new in Modern Warfare, and it was a pretty cool changeup because they were kind of going after Battlefield's market there. But now it seems like they're holding the reins back, which is kind of concerning to me, or maybe they just noticed that it didn't do as well. Maybe Ground War isn't doing as well in Modern Warfare, or maybe Treyarch just wanted to switch up the thing and just have normal Ground War 12v12, because that is what we're getting. We do have certain maps that work just for Ground War and for 6v6. Obviously, these Ground War maps, if they're played in 6v6, they're going to be super, super slow. Don't know why they're still doing that with Call of Duty games. Obviously, you need to have certain maps built out for certain game types, which I liked more in Modern Warfare. Sniper Glint seems to be gone. At least how fast, obviously, someone can snipe you in this game. It seems insane. You can do that, obviously, in Modern Warfare as well, but it doesn't seem like Sniper Glint is that big of a focus in this. Tactical Sprint, completely gone from the game. If you don't know what Tactical Sprint is, it's when you're running in Modern Warfare and your guy, like, runs with a gun up in the air. It's basically just a super sprint before it goes back down to normal sprint speed. That is completely gone from the game. Ladder animations. I don't know why this is taken out. This was it was just an improved feature, I would say, in any FPS, is when you can actually see your arms on the ladder climbing up, and then you can have that pistol once you, like, stop on the ladder, and you can aim and shoot off. That was kind of a neat feature. That doesn't really specifically need to be on the ladder animation. I just would like to see the arms going up. I think it's kind of cheesy and lame that they didn't add that into this. Obviously, this is an alpha build, so it might change, but it just seems kind of cheesy and kind of lazy to me to not have that feature in when Modern Warfare already had that. Mounting, there's no more mounting in the game whatsoever, so you don't have to worry about little head glitchers mounting up, laser beaming you across the map anymore. There's no more doors, so you don't have to worry about anyone slamming doors open constantly throughout the match. That kind of, like, got rid of footsteps and gun sounds and stuff once in a while because the doors were exceedingly loud for no reason. Silencers do not increase damage range anymore, which is, obviously, if you're not new to Call of Duty, they never did. But in Modern Warfare, the Monolithic Suppressor and then the Colossus Suppressor, depending on what guns you were using, obviously, increased damage range. And I think there was a couple more suppressors that were in Modern Warfare that increased damage range. But in this game, so far in the alpha build that was shown, none of these silencers increased damage range whatsoever. They actually decreased damage range, which is very interesting, because going over to Warzone, Yikes, that is going to be a change and a half. Mantling to any roof and to the top of, like, anything, basically, is not a thing in this game right now. In Modern Warfare, they kind of used it as, like, a sandboxy, like, you can get to any rooftop, get to any spot. You could climb onto anything, basically. In this game, it's more typical Call of Duty. It's just you're on the map. You're on your three lanes. There are some things you can get up to if you can climb up to that height. Otherwise, you can't get on top of it. If you can't get on top of it, there's no way to get on top of it. They'll have invisible barriers on it, and you can't get on top of it. In Modern Warfare, it was pretty much the complete opposite unless you were trying to get outside of the map. And to round out this video, this is going to make a lot of C4 meta users very angry, and this is going to change the meta or the landscape of how Warzone is played if this is implemented in. But C4s can no longer be detonated mid-air with double tapping X, double tapping square, double tapping any interact button that you have bound to this to make it detonate, and it just doesn't do it anymore. So you can't throw your C4 and blow it up mid-air. You have to wait until it hits an object or lands on the ground for you to detonate. I don't know why Treyarch does this, but they've done it since Black Ops 3. It just makes C4 pretty much completely useless when they do this. I don't know why, because they already have Flak Jacket in the game, and that pretty much defeats the purpose of C4s being any sort of use out of them, unless maybe their damage range is bigger now because you have to wait until they hit the ground. We'll see how they do it. To me, I'm probably not going to use C4 as much, and in Warzone, if this is a transferred over feature, C4 might not be as used as much or as abused as much, which might be a good thing and a bad thing. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down below about all these features that have been removed in Call of Duty Cold War's multiplayer compared to Modern Warfare. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Drop a like on it. If you hated this video, drop a dislike on it. Doesn't really matter to me, and I will see you guys in the next one.